If you need to create a bootable Linux USB drive from within Windows, these are two of the best programs you can find. One is very user-friendly, and another one is more flexible and little more advanced. Let's have a look at them. Hello everyone, it's a Linux user, helping you to install, configure and use Linux. If you are watching this video, this means you have done the right decision. You are going to install Linux. And to install it, you need to create a bootable USB. But the only OS you have is Windows. Don't worry, you can create a bootable Linux USB from within Windows pretty easy. In this video, I will show you one very simple option, it is Etcher. This is very simple graphical program to make a bootable USB. If you are not comfortable with computers, this option is for you. If you are a little more advanced user and you want to have a little more control, I will show you another program. This is a program called Rufus. It is more reliable and a little bit more flexible than the previous one. So, let's get started. First, you need to download and install Etcher program. To do that, you go to the website etcher.io. And it usually automatically detects your system. If it hasn't detected your system, you can click here and select Windows of your version. So in my case, I use Windows 32 bits. So I click here. So you click save. When the image is saved, you go to your downloads folder and double click on the downloaded file. Click run. Agree with the license. So when the program is installed, you just need to select an image you want to burn to your USB drive. For example, let's assume you want to burn Linux Mint image to your USB drive. You need to download the Linux Mint image. You go to download. You select the version of Linux Mint you want to download. Select the nearest server to your location. Save the image. Click select image. And select the image you want to write to USB drive. Usually Etcher detects your USB drive automatically. If it has not detected it, or it has detected the wrong one, you can click here and change it. I have only one flash drive available, so I will keep it as it is. After that, it's just simple to click flash. And the image will be written to the USB drive. You might be asked to confirm that you want to write this ISO image to USB drive, so to do that you click yes. Depending on the configuration of your Windows system, you may also need to type your administrative password. This is normal, just do that, and after that, wait until the image is written to the USB drive. It may take several minutes. After ISO image is written and validated, you can reboot your system and select to boot from the USB device. You should be able to boot into your Linux system. Let's download Rufus. We go to the Rufus website. If you scroll a little down, you will see downloads option. We need the latest version here, but you have also option to download portable software or some previous versions. Save the file. When the download is finished, go to your downloads folder and double click on the downloaded file. You may need to give it permission to run on your computer. You may also need to type your administrative password. So this is the program. The interface is quite simple, but maybe a little overwhelming if you're not familiar with all these options. So that's why I say that Rufus is better for more advanced users, but Etcher is easier to use and it works also in most of the cases. If you have problems with Etcher and you cannot boot from the bootable USB, you may need to go to Rufus and try different options here. So the first option is you need to select your USB flash drive here. In my case, I have only one USB drive here, so it automatically detected my USB disk. But if you have several USB drives, so they may be shown here, so be careful to select the right one. You can see the label of that USB and also its size. Based on that, select it. And as you can see, if I keep my mouse pointer here, it also shows me the name of my USB drive. It's a Samsung flash drive. Next, you need to select type of partition you want to use. So you can see some information here. So this is MBR option, works in most of the cases, and it, as you can see, it is selected by default. but some more recent hardware, they require GPT partition and it's only UEFI mode. So if it happens that the first version didn't work for you, so you have created a USB drive with this option, but it didn't boot or something goes wrong, you can go back and recreate a bootable USB drive with this GPT partition scheme. So you will keep it as it was by default. For the file system, you have several options here. I don't really see the point of this option, but maybe if you have very, very large ISO image, you may need to use XT4 and TFS file system, but FAT32 will work fine in most of the cases. The size of your cluster is usually detected automatically based on the type of your USB drive, so keep it by default. Here you can give it a label, and I believe after writing the image to the USB drive, this label will change anyway, so you can skip it. Next, if like you are not sure about your flash drive, or for example you have created a bootable USB drive but it didn't work, you have tried to change different options here, it still doesn't work, you may check your USB drive for bad blocks. Maybe something is damaged on your USB drive and it is a problem in your USB drive, not in ISO image. So that's one of the options you can use. We will not use it in this case because my USB drive is fine. You can also may try to use kind of more serious formatting, because this is quick format, so it saves time, but it doesn't completely wipe all the information from your flash drive. But for us it's okay, and I think in most of the cases you can use quick format, but if you want to make a bootable USB drive completely new, you can then remove the stick and make kind of more deep formatting of your USB drive. I will keep it for now. Here again you have several options to create different type of bootable USB drive. So you can use FreeDOS, this is I think what Rufus recommends, because MS-DOS may not work in some cases. You can also use ISO image and DD image. If you have used Linux before, you probably know what is DD here. So basically it's like a direct writing of an ISO image to your file. But in this case we will use ISO image because we want to write ISO image to a USB drive. And you click on this disk icon to select an ISO. This is a Linux Mint ISO we have downloaded previously. So let's write it to a USB. So this is, I'm not really sure exactly what it means, but maybe if you use different languages, so that's, it's selected by default, so I usually keep it by default, but I don't think it matters a lot, so let's keep it selected. After you have checked all the options and they are what you want, you can click start here. So you see, Rufus is pretty smart, it has detected some differences in version between ISO image and the program version which is included in Rufus. And it recommends you to download these files automatically and use them automatically. So it's good to say yes here. So after that, Rufus is again demonstrating his smartness. It provides you two additional options you can use. You can use ISO image mode, that's what we have selected, but you can also use DD image mode. And I have said that DD is like kind of a more Linux way to write the image to the USB drive. But ISO image mode is recommended, so if it is recommended, I would recommend you to keep this option. But again, if it happens that your USB drive doesn't work, like you cannot boot from it for example, you can go back and try to change this option. Maybe writing image in DD mode is what you need, and this will make your USB drive bootable. But for now, we will keep it with ISO image mode. I usually use this option and it works pretty well. Click OK. So the final warning is that all the data from your flash drive will be removed. So be careful, if you store any important files on your USB drive, you better cancel here, go back and copy that information. Otherwise, if you click OK, everything will be wiped out from your USB drive. So I don't have any sensitive information on my USB drive, so I click OK here. So the writing process has started, and depending on the size of the ISO image you want to write, it may take a while, so you need to wait it. For this video, I will just speed up this process to save your time. So when the writing is finished, this bar will be completely filled and you will see the word ready. So this means your USB drive is ready to use for booting. If there was an error or something didn't work, you can also click on this lock button and see the lock process of the writing of this ISO image to your USB drive. As you can see, it is pretty long here. But everything seems to be fine here. So just close it, close Rufus, and go and boot from a USB drive. You just need to restart your computer and select the USB drive during the boot process. So now you should be able to create a bootable Linux USB drive from within Windows without any problem. Just use Etcher, it usually works fine. In case if you want to have more control or if Etcher didn't work, you can also use Rufus. It is perceived as more reliable too, but in my view Etcher works fine and I personally use it myself if I need to create a bootable USB drive from within Windows. It is very simple, very quick and very easy to use. So I hope your installation process will be smooth and you will enjoy your Linux experience. If you have problems making a bootable USB drive or you have any general questions about Linux, leave them under this video. I will do my best to help you. Welcome to the Linux world and thank you for watching.